Good afternoon and welcome to Bobcat Update. The San Marcos mayoral debate is taking center stage here in San Marcos. I'm Travis Tyler.
And Texas State's tuition is continually increasing, which has many Bobcats up in arms. I'm Matt Vianney. Thanks for joining us. Texas State's university plans to increase tuition next fall. University officials held a hearing in the LBJ Student Center Wednesday to discuss the increase. The plan not only increases the designated tuition, but also the student success fee and the student center fee. It will amount to a 3.95% increase for in-state undergraduates when they pay their tuition and fees. Full-time students on average will pay about $200 more per semester. University officials will ask the Board of Regents for a formal approval next month.
KTSW and the University Star hosted a debate involving the candidates for mayor last night. Students and faculty attended the event at the LBJ Student Center to see where candidates stood on important issues such as river preservation, education, taxes, and bridging the gap between San Marcos residents and the Texas State University. Early voting will continue November 4th. Election day is November 8th. San Marcos will elect a new mayor and several city council members.
Police are bringing the scare this Halloween with their No Refusal initiative. This allows officers to issue a blood search warrant on the spot if you refuse to be tested or if they suspect you of drunk driving. Last year, 41 people were arrested under the same initiative. Those looking for an alternative means of transportation can use rideshare apps such as Fare, Z-Trip, or Ride Austin. The initiative starts Friday at 9 p.m. and continues until early Tuesday morning.
It's been about 2 months since ITT Technical Institute shut down its for-profit schools nationwide. Former students have struggled to bounce back and return to the classroom. Programs differ from school to school, which makes it harder to transition. Challenges for nursing students include whether their credits can transfer elsewhere. Another issue is the extra time it will take to graduate as a registered nurse.
The latest CNN presidential poll is showing Hillary Clinton leading Donald Trump by 6 percentage points. The 5 most recent national surveys have shown Clinton with 47% support to Trump's 41%. Libertarian Gary Johnson is at 5%, and Jill Stein of the Green Party has 2%. The 2016 election will be November 8th. A new app is allowing restaurants to hook in new customers by offering exclusive deals. Malik Mingo tells us more in this Bobcat Update.
The number one college food and drink app has made its way to San Marcos. Hooked is an app that offers deals to its users at restaurants in the area. Places like Chimmy's, Valentino's, and Potbelly's have all partnered with the app to offer exclusive deals.
We decided to use it to help draw in business and to give back to the students a little bit.
Once you sign up for the app, it will bring up a variety of coupons customers can start using the same day. However, most of the coupons have an expiration date.
So we don't always want to just offer everybody the same deal. We want to switch it up where it's variety, where we keep bringing in people different days or to try different things out. Sometimes people come in twice a day to try 2 different cookies out with the deal.
The app is similar to an old-fashioned coupon book, but Potbelly store manager Adam Gonzalez says the app is great because it is mobile.
A lot of students don't check any of their move-in packets or things like that, but they definitely check their phone. And the cool thing about it is the kids can decide from either their house or from school where they're going to go eat at based off of the Hook deal that they feel that's better.
Many people are already using the benefits that Hook offers. Chandler McIntyre says she used the app at her job and it saved her around $8 to $10.
I think the food itself was $12.95, so it was around like $6 for the handheld, and then our beers are anywhere from like $4.50, $5.50, so it was $2 off of that.
San Marcos is a college town where students often seek discounts or good deals to save money. McIntyre says that using an app like Hooked when choosing a place to eat can be very beneficial.
Because I save money. So anything I can get cheaper for free, I'm going to take it.
If you don't want to travel off campus, you can also use the Hooked app at several dining places on campus, such as Panda Express, Wood Street Pizza, and Wing It.
The new Hooked app can be found on all Apple or Android devices. All you need to do is download the app, sign in with Facebook or email, and see what new stores can start hooking you. For Bobcat Update, I'm Malik Mingo.
Online daily deals giant Groupon is buying out its rival, Living Social. Groupon announced the deal Wednesday. Both companies launched nearly a decade ago and flooded customers' inboxes with deals for restaurants, retailers, and other items nationwide. However, times have changed for both Groupon. It now focuses on customers searching its site for deals, while Social recently highlighted its fun experiences for customers. The deal is expected to finalize next month. Homecoming week inspired many Texas State organizations to step up and help the community. One example was the Omicron Psi chapter of Zeta Phi Beta. Bobcat Update's Colleen Payne has the story.
The sorority hosted Hump Day, a hygiene product drive to benefit the homeless shelter.
Soaps and shampoos, conditioners, toothbrushes.
Service was the focus of the event, but that didn't stop people from having a great time.
It's a big, it's like a kind of campus party, but it's a gathering, it's a social, you'll meet people, and it's a like stress reliever in the middle of the week.
The event was a part of Zeta Week, a string of events the sorority hosted for homecoming to showcase Bobcat spirit and community pride.
We were like, well, how about use one of our events that bring a lot of people and have it collectively, not just be a Zeta thing, be the whole community at Texas State.
Homecoming was the initial motive for the daily celebrations, but the sorority year-round also emphasizes scholarship, service, sisterhood, and finer womanhood.
I got in here, I got to be myself, I picked up a position, and it's the best choice I've ever made.
A community-conscious and action-oriented organization is the motto for the Omicron Z chapter of Zeta Phi Beta. Through homecoming events such as this one, they embody just that. For Bobcat Update, I'm Colleen Payne.
KTSW is celebrating Mass Comm Week by showcasing its new home in the Trinity Building. Renovations began last summer that effectively converged the student media operations under the same room. KTSW moved from Old Main, where it had been for more than 20 years, to Trinity, which is where the University Star moved several years ago. An open house for the joint operation was held this morning for anyone who wanted to come by and see the building's new design.
Coming up, Microsoft and Apple are competing to release their new products before the holiday season.
The Main Street program works with local businesses to make downtown a place for you to love. Named most romantic Main Street in the U.S. Home to local restaurants, shops, and businesses. Friendly faces await, so stop in and say hi. San Marcos may be growing, but will always be a small town at heart. Shop, eat, study, and play downtown. For information and events, find the Main Street program on the City of San Marcos website. The San Marcos Main Street program. Love local, shop downtown.
October is Cybersecurity Awareness Month. Texas State's Information Security Office is encouraging students to be very cautious when using the internet. There are many potential criminals who would like to gain access to personal records, such as names, social security numbers, and bank account information. Safe internet practices include never sharing your net ID and password, and not using the same password for multiple sites. It's also a good idea to never open emails from an unknown sender.
Microsoft unveiled its first all-in-one touchscreen desktop this week. The $3,000 PC features a 4-core i7 chip, a 2-terabyte hard drive, HD camera, and 13.5 million pixels. The computer also has a built-in microphone that allows users to speak to voice assistant software from across the room. The Surface Studio will be available in limited supplies for the holiday season.
Don't expect Apple's new wireless earbuds to hit the market anytime soon. Apple unveiled Apple AirPods in September, but the company says it needs a little more time to get them ready for sale. For the 2016 fiscal year, the company's annual sales have fallen about 8%, resulting in an $18 billion decline from last year. The company hasn't reported any annual loss since 2001 when it first introduced the AirPod.
While walking through the quad, it's not uncommon for students and faculty to come across preachers in the free speech area. This week, Cliff Connectly, a pastor from Connecticut, stationed himself next to the stallions to talk with students about the gospel. Connectly has been preaching at universities across the country for over 30 years. He invites students to ask him questions about Christianity. All of his talks are filmed and uploaded to his website, Give Me an Answer. Connectly will be in the quad from noon to 3 tomorrow.
Halloween will be celebrated this weekend, and the university has some activities to help you get in the spirit. Larissa Rodriguez has more on this story.
This past week, the Alkeck Library hosted the spooky movie Night of the Living Dead as part of its film series. While the movie played, snacks were served, and some attendees painted pumpkins and created Halloween crafts.
This month is October, it's Halloween time, so we decided we'd get a little spooky and have Night of the Living Dead. And so what we do, we show a film, we've started doing crafts as well, and we also always have snacks.
I figured I'd just stay on campus and take a break from studying and come see the movie, get some snacks.
To find out about more fun events held on campus, check out the events calendar on the Texas State website. For Bobcat Update, I'm Larissa Rodriguez.
Well, that'll do it for today's Bobcat Update. Thanks for joining us.
Bobcat Update will be back next Wednesday for more of your Texas State and local area news. Have a great weekend.